Hello friends and welcome to all of you to my English YouTube channel. Now before going to say something, let us begin with a question, a simple question. What do you think or what is the difference between human and animals? Ready for this question? According to my knowledge, my answer is animals are animals, they can't be human. But humans are humans, but sometimes they can behave like animals, like wild animals, like jungly animals. Indeed, very interesting title, animals, and the same title today we are going to open, animals in form of a poem written by Walt Whitman, one who respect the animal, one who become more comfortable in the company of animal than the human. Walt Whitman is American poet, or he is from the America, and he is known for his free verse type of poetry. Okay, more information in the small introductory paragraph. Here we are going to collect and discuss Walt Whitman. He was born in 1819. He was died in 1892. A major figure in early American poetry. In an age when all poetry was rhymed and metrical, Whitman made a break with the tradition and wrote a revolutionary new kind of poetry, that is in free verse. Indeed, means the poems are known for its rhythm, poems are known for its rhyming words, isn't it? Or poems are known especially for its musical tune. But the person Walt Whitman, he had done a revolution in English poetry, and he introduced the whole world with a new form, that is free verse poetry. Isn't it? Free verse poetry, which doesn't consist rhyming words, which doesn't consist any musical melodious tune. Next is, he was non-conformist in all respect. Isn't it? He was non-conformist. Non-conformist means a person, one who is against the religion, one who doesn't accept religious ideas very blindly. And therefore, he was non-conformist, yes, everywhere and in his social life too. Yes, more thing that poet tells us, he feels more at home with animals than humans, what he finds complicated and false. Indeed, sometimes the person, somewhere he feels more comfortable, more happy, more relaxed in company of animals, and he doesn't find the same in the company of humans. बरोबर म्हणजे प्राण्यांबरोबरती राहताना जेवढं कम्फर्टेबल किंवा जेवढं रिलॅक्स ते फील करतात, तेवढं रिलॅक्स किंवा कम्फर्टेबल यस व्यक्तींबरोबर किंवा माणसांबरोबर राहताना कधीही त्यांना अनुभवता आलं नाही, कधीही ते त्यांनी अनुभवलेलं नाही. Therefore, without any delay, yes, animals from page number 46. I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-content. I stand and look at them long and long. Once again, I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-content. Okay, according to poet, he tells us that he feels more comfortable, or he feels more relaxed in the company of animals, and therefore why, the reason it is given, they are so placid, they are self-content, they never become upset very easily like human, and they are self-sufficient, they do not belong to others. I stand and look at them long and long, and because of that, isn't it? Such type of quality, it attracts me towards animal, and because of that, I look at them, I remain in touch of animals for long time or for long and long period. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. And once again, they do not sweat and whine about their condition. Now, keep animals away for 2 minutes and think about the humans. Isn't it? Human people, or take an example of a man. Isn't it? A man, yes, he always feels so much tired after the hard work or after the struggle. And a man, one who doesn't like the proper work, he always makes a complaint about that proper work which he dislikes. जे काम त्यांना आवडत नाही त्या कामाबद्दल नेहमी तक्रार करणारे अनेक लोक आपण समाजामध्ये बघतो, परंतु अशा तक्रारी मात्र प्राणी कधीही करत नाही. कधी कधी मी फार थकलोय असं देखील आपण बोलू शकतो, परंतु प्राणी किंवा ॲनिमल्स असं कधीही बोलू शकत नाही की हे काम मला आवडत नाही किंवा ते काम करून मी आता खूप थकलोय किंवा आता मला कंटाळा आलाय. ओके, दे डू नॉट लाय अवे इन द डार्क अँड वीप फॉर देअर सिन्स. इंटरेस्टिंग वन, दे डू नॉट लाय अवेक इन द डार्क. म्हणजे टू लाय अवेक इन द डार्क, इट इज अ नेचर ऑफ ह्युमन. मीन्स नेहमी एखादी गोष्ट थोडीशी खोटं बोलणं किंवा एखादं काम जर करायचं नसेल तर एखादी थाप मारणं, दॅट इज द म्हणायचं टेंडन्सी बिहेवियर ऑफ ह्युमन बीइंग्स, बट इट कांट बी डन बाय द ॲनिमल्स. राईट, दे नेवर कंप्लेन, दे नेवर लाय ऑर दे नेवर क्राय फॉर देअर क्रिटिकल कंडिशन अँड फॉर देअर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड लाईफ. अँड द सेंटेन्स इज, दे डू नॉट लाय अवे इन द डार्क and weep for their sins. They do not feel very sad or they do not feel so much sorrow for their mistake as we people feels when we people commit the different types of mistakes. Next is, they do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one is dissatisfied, not one is demented. Isn't it? Sentence is, they do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Isn't it? What is our duty towards the God? Isn't it? We people always complain to the God, yes, myself, I am born in a poor family. Isn't it? Myself, I am a failure of my life. Myself, I am still struggling to develop or to gain something in my life. Okay, such type of complaints we people always put in front of God early in the morning or somewhere, yes, at the time of evening during our prayers. बरोबर, मला हे मिळालं नाही, मला ते मिळालं नाही, किंवा माझं आयुष्य फार गरिबीचं आहे, मी फार स्ट्रगल करतो, अशा एक ना अनेक तक्रारी आपण नेहमी देवासमोर मांडत असतो. म्हणजे आपण पूजा, देवाची पूजा आपण कमी करतो, आपल्या तक्रारी जास्त मांडतो, परंतु अशा तक्रारी करण्याची संधी देखील या बिचाऱ्या प्राण्यांना मिळत नाही. अँड देअरफोर सेंटेन्स इज दॅट दे डू नॉट मेक मी सिक. ओके, आय एम नॉट सफरिंग. मेनी ॲनिमल्स आर देअर, बट आय नेवर सफर बिकॉज ऑफ देअर कंप्लेन, अँड दे डू नॉट कंप्लेन अगेन्स्ट द गॉड अबाउट देअर ड्युटी. नॉट वन इज डिससॅटिस्फाईड, नॉट वन इज डिमेंटेड. इंडीड, नोबडी इज डिससॅटिस्फाईड अँड नोबडी इज मॅड लाईक ह्युमन. दोज ह्युमन्स, दोज हू आर रनिंग बिहाइंड द सक्सेस व्हेरी मॅडली ऑर फुल लाईक पर्सन. बरोबर, म्हणजे सक्सेस, यश, यश शोधण्यासाठी, सक्सेस शोधण्यासाठी, पैसा कमवण्यासाठी आपण एखाद्या मूर्ख व्यक्तीसाठी व्यक्तीसारखं पळत असतो. परंतु असं पळणं आणि धावणं किंवा नको त्या गोष्टीमागं धावणं, नको त्या गोष्टींचा अट्टहास करणं, या गोष्टींपासून हे प्राणी नेहमी परावृत्त असतात. या गोष्टी ते कधीही करत नाही आणि कॉज ऑफ दॅट दे आर नोन ॲज सॅटिस्फाईड अँड हॅपी ॲनिमल्स, यस, इन द लाईफ. नेक्स्ट इज, नॉट वन इज डिससॅटिस्फाईड, नॉट वन इज डिमेंटेड विथ द मॅनिया ऑफ ओनिंग थिंग्स. And it means whatever they have and whatever with them, they are happy. Isn't it? But we people never remain happy. Why? Because our thirst of earning, yes, it is totally unlimited. Isn't it? I want to earn this, I want to grab this, I want to achieve this. Yes, this is known as the thirst. Hi gosht paije, ti gosht havi ahe, ti gosht malas paije, yala bolnar, yes, ek thirst. ती मिळवताना आपण मात्र स्वतःची परवड करतो आणि आपण नेहमी दुःखी असतो. परंतु प्राण्यांच्या बाबतीत ही गोष्ट कधीही घडत नाही. दे आर ऑलवेज हॅपी व्हॉट एवर दे हॅव राईट प्रेझेंट. दे नेवर केअर अबाउट टुमॉरो. नो वन नीड्स टू अनादर नॉट टू हिज काइंड दॅट. नो सी, बाय एक्सप्लेनिंग द कंडिशन, बाय एक्सप्लेनिंग द ट्रूथ अबाउट द ॲनिमल, हियर पोएट ही टेल्स अस ऑर ही ओपन द ट्रूथ ऑफ ह्युमन. Humans are not satisfied, humans are always unhappy, humans are selfish people, isn't it? And for that purposes, time to time, humans, they behave like a polite person, sometimes they immediately surrender to fulfill their demands, yes, in front of God, but in front of the particular people. आपल्या स्वतःच्या डिमांड पूर्ण करण्यासाठी देखील पटकन एखादा व्यक्ती, यस, गुडघे टेकून सरेंडर देखील होतो आणि मला ही काहीतरी गोष्ट दे म्हणून हात पसरतो. आपण देखील, म्हणजे देवाची पूजा करणं ही गोष्ट चांगली, परंतु देवाची पूजा आपण कमी करतो, अनेक गोष्टी मागण्याचा प्रयत्न देवाकडे करतो, तीच गोष्ट मात्र प्राण्यांच्या बाबतीत कधीही घडत नाही. आणि म्हणून त्यांची कंपनी वॉल्ट व्हिटमन यांना जास्त भावते, जास्त आवडते. ओके, नो वन गिव्स टू अनदर नॉर टू हिज काइंड दॅट लिव्ह थाउजंड ऑफ इयर्स अगो. Not an example of animals. Animals, they do not kneel in front of each other, isn't it? Animals do not make complaint. Same as it is, animals never kneel in front of each other in their system or in their caste. प्राण्यांप्राण्यांमध्ये देखील अशी गोष्ट कधीही घडत नाही, एकदम तर आपण काय बोलतोय, सरेंडर होणं किंवा एकदम काहीतरी गोष्ट मागणं, ही गोष्ट फक्त व्यक्तींच्या किंवा माणसांच्याच बाबतीत घडते, प्राण्यांच्या बाबतीत मात्र नाही. नेक्स्ट इज, नो वन इज रिस्पेक्टेबल ऑर अनहॅपी ओवर द होल अर्थ, सो दे शो देअर रिलेशन्स टू मी अँड आय ॲक्सेप्ट देम. वन्स अगेन, नॉट वन इज रिस्पेक्टेबल ऑर अनहॅपी over the whole earth. All right, animals, they are not much happy, isn't it? Or animals, they doesn't show so much unhappiness. Every time they are calm, every time they remain silent, isn't it? They never show the aggression, they never show the hunger like human, and cause of that, this type of behavior, not happy, not unhappy, okay, totally neutral, such type of behavior, it attracts the person Walt Whitman. Next is, they bring me tokens of myself, they evince, okay, they bring me token of myself, they evince them plainly in their possession, isn't it? Sometimes they offer me a token, isn't it? A token of innocence, a token of virtues and contentment, isn't it? That is known as the behavior of human, isn't it? To keep the moral lesson, to behave like the human, actually these are the natural behavior of human, but somewhere we have forgotten such type of behavior, and we people behave like the cruel animal, or we people behave like the animals. Like, whatever lesson I have forgotten in my life, all that good and wise lessons, they are taught by animals in my life with their company, and so I like the company of animals more than humans. It is the sentence. Next is, I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? Isn't it? I wonder where they get those tokens. Isn't it? Now these are known as the gifts. Okay, wisdom, or to be humble, or to forgive the mistake of others. Alright, these are the God-gifted quality that we have to bestow and we have to practice in our daily life. But nowadays we have forgotten all that gifts which God has given, and in our selfish manner we have already become like animals or like cruel animals. Same tokens which are gifted by God to humans, same tokens I find in the company of animals, and somewhere I remember, yes, their tokens, they belongs to me, and I have once again backed all that tokens from animals. Therefore, he thanks to animal. I wonder where they get those tokens. Did I pass that way huge times ago and negligently drop them? Alright, since many years ago, I have received all that tokens from the God, but maybe possible somewhere they are remained behind, and now all that tokens, they are coming in front of me. Yes, they are brought by animals, and because of that, I like the company of God, which teaches me all that things which are gifted by the God only for humans. Isn't it? Means, through this poem, we have to understand, yes, every time we have to love, respect, and we have to use our mercy for the animals. Why? Because animals are also known as the part of nature, and we should respect them, we should treat them more politely in our life. Hope you people have understood the poem. Thank you and have a nice day.